In this illustration, we'll calculate the moment of inertia of a hemisphere. Here, we are required to find moment of inertia of a hemisphere of mass m and radius r about the tangential axis shown in the figure. Now, in this situation, here, we can make use of parallel axis theorem. Like, if I draw the figure again, this is the hemisphere of which we wish to find the moment of inertia about the tangential axis. Then we know the moment of inertia of the hemisphere about an axis passing through its center and in the plane of its base. This moment of inertia we can write as I1. So we can write MI of a hemisphere about an axis of rotation in its base and passing through center is this I1 we write by symmetry, we can write it as 2/5 mr², which is the same result as that of complete sphere, as in this case the mass of hemisphere is given as m and its radius is given as r. Now, using this moment of inertia, we can find out the moment of inertia about an axis which is passing through its center of mass and parallel to this. As this distance of the axis passing through center of mass and parallel to its axis in its base, this distance we know it is given as 3r/8. So we can write here moment of inertia of a hemisphere about axis of rotation passing through its center of mass. You can see in first case we have calculated about the axis passing through its center. Now we are calculating the moment of inertia about an axis which is passing through center of mass, we can write it as IC. In the value of IC, we can write as I1, because by parallel axis theorem, we can write I1 as IC + MD². So here the value of IC will be I1 - m multiplied by 3r/8². I've taken this MD² on the other side. So this will be mr² multiplied by this 2/5 - 9/64. As we have got the value of IC, we can calculate the moment of inertia I about the tangential axis of rotation. So here moment of inertia about tangential axis of rotation as given in figure is this we can give by parallel axis theorem again, that IC + MD² and this distance is r - 3r/8, which is 5r/8. So it will be m multiplied by 5r/8². So if we substitute the value of IC over here, this will give us mr² 2/5 - 9/64. Plus mr², this is multiplied by 25/64. So we simplify this relation. This finally gives us 13/20 mr², that is the result of this problem.